Professional movies are enhanced by many types of moving camera shots. Taken from tracks, jibs, cranes, drones, gimbals, camera cars, and helicopters. But hey, I just shoot for fun, and my budget is lower than lizard lips. Inexpensive tracks, portable jibs, sliders, and gimbals are available and have their place. But I need lightweight, easy-to-use equipment, with a wide variety of motions and effects. Also, the best bang for the buck. Two new products and an old favorite give me the freedom I need at a price I can afford. The first GoPro was released in 2004, but it, and its early successors, produced mostly jerky, fisheye views of the world. Starting with the Hero 7, released in 2019, they now offer normal views of subjects and exceptional image stabilization. They can be mounted almost anywhere to shoot creative angles. I got mine for $250. This Hero is mounted on a hinge, which maintains a level horizon. At the end of this boom pole, it can shoot low, sweeping shots, poke into tight corners, and mimic both jib and slider shots. The Hero 7 can shoot stills and time-lapse video. The DJI Mavic Mini was also released in 2019. This tiny drone shoots very nice footage from high and low vantage points. It can shoot stills and mimic crane, tracking, and tripod shots. I got mine for $399. I bought this Sony PXW-X70 when it was released in 2014. It has professional audio inputs, good image stabilization, and a motorized zoom. Used X70s cost about $1,600. There are many cheaper if less capable cameras. The Hero, Mini, and Sony, without its audio handle, fit comfortably into this backpack. The loaded pack weighs 12 pounds and is comfortable when I hike or ride my motorcycle. With a combination of three cameras, my creative horizons are unbounded. How does it work? One movie's worth thousands of words. So let's see.